Kuldeep sent me this really nice keyless drill press chuck. Unfortunately, the taper on it is too large for my small drill presses and too small for my big drill press. The way these chucks are mounted on the drill press is they fit on a conical taper on here, and just by pushing them on there firmly, that gets them stuck. And in the act of drilling, you push on it way more than rotation, so the tricky part is actually not getting it on, but getting it off. So I was thinking I could adapt this chuck to be used on my lathe, and for that I've got an extra piece of 16 millimeter shaft, which is the same size I've got in here, and this shaft is large enough to get stuck in the taper, but it's not quite thick enough for the end of the taper, so I have to pad that up a little bit. So I've taken some very careful measurements of the inside of the taper, and I figure I'll just weld some beads onto here to try to bring it up to thickness and then grind it down. The other problem is I have to use the end with the flat part on it because this shaft is just barely long enough to go into my headstock here. Got my welding bench set up and I've set up this hose to blow the smoke through this fan outside. I think you can appreciate why I don't make any how to weld videos. I put a block of wood on the shaft to protect it from welding splatter, but that was only partially effective. Now I just need to precision grind that into a taper using an angle grinder, and I'll try to do that on my lathe. Just gotta fix that wobble by adjusting the four-jawed chuck. Well, I guess that 50-cent nut driver was only worth 50 cents. Well, I think that's centered enough. There's still quite a bit of run out here. It's still got a bit of wiggle room. And I keep checking with the dial indicator where the center of the rocking appears to be. It appears to be right about here, which suggests that that's where it's getting hung up. It should be right here. Because it's very difficult to get that whole cone right with an angle grinder, I figured I'd just have two rings that would make contact, one on the outside and one on the inside, and so that would be much easier. And I'd worked out the slope of this, so I knew what diameter it should be in here, and I ground it to that diameter and that diameter, but what I kept getting is it was actually always wiggling here, or about this point, it seemed it was never making contact here. So I built up the bead again and screwed up again and built up the bead again, and it was getting very frustrating. And it turns out the taper isn't continuously going down like this. It's actually a partial taper and then it goes to cylindrical. And what I was trying to hit at the bottom of this taper, that didn't actually exist. And so I made the rings closer together and that worked much better. Well, this is as good as it's going to get. One thing I've resorted to is to put a paper shim in here because I ground it down too far. That sounded pretty good despite the paper shim. Good enough for a lathe. Being able to mount this chuck on the shaft is actually something that would make building a homemade drill press feasible. And this is what my dreadful handiwork looks like. Despite all the frustrations, I think this technique has potential. Just this application is a very demanding one. So with a drill chuck on here, I can use the lathe to make lots of little drawer knobs like this. But this chuck is actually not quite optimal. If you try this sort of thing, I'd recommend actually using a keyed chuck, not a keyless one, because this one tightens itself as torque is applied, so it tightens too much on the wood, and it's also quite long. A shorter keyed chuck would be much more stable. Also, a Jacob's chuck like this is not ideal for side loads, and I've had this one actually fall off the shaft on me once so far.